let us learn about spherical lenses.
What is a lens? A lens is a transparent refracting medium. Transparent means it allows the light rays to pass through it. We know the property of refraction of light. Lens is a transparent refracting medium and it is bounded by either two spherical surfaces or one spherical surface and the other surface plane. In A and C, they are bounded by two spherical surfaces. In B and D, one surface is spherical and the other surface is plane. For a lens, one surface must be spherical. At least one surface must be spherical. Simple lenses are of two types, convex lens and concave lens. Convex lens will be thicker at the center and thinner at the edges. Whereas for a concave lens, it will be thinner at the center and thicker at the edges. Convex lens is known as converging lens and concave lens is known as diverging lens. I hope you remember the spherical mirrors we learned in part 4. Now we are going to learn something similar to that. This convex lens is a part of these two spheres. Let C1 be the center of curvature of this sphere and C2 be the center of curvature of this sphere. The line joining between these two center of curvatures is known as principal axis. The center of the lens is known as optical center and it is represented by the letter O. This is the center. Convex lens are known as converging lens. As you can see from this diagram, these incident light rays are converged at this point, which is called focus. Whereas for a concave lens, these incident light rays are diverging after refraction. That is why concave lens is known as diverging lens. This is a diagram of a convex lens bounded by two spherical surfaces. As you have two spherical surfaces, you have two center of curvatures, C1 and C2. C1 is 2F1 and C2 is 2F2. And two focal points, F1 and F2. The line joining between the C1 and C2, this line is called as principal axis. This line is called as principal axis. The distance between the optical center and the focus, this distance is called as focal length, represented by F. Focal length F. Note that this is a convex lens bounded by two spherical surfaces and hence you have two focal points and two center of curvatures. You must know these rules to draw the ray diagrams. The first rule is that if the incident light ray is parallel to the principal axis, then after refraction, it passes through the principal focus on the other side of the lens. The second rule is that if the incident ray passes through the focus, then after refraction, it passes parallel to the principal axis. The third rule is that if the incident ray passes through the optical center, then the ray goes undeviated. In this convex lens, these incident rays are parallel to the principal axis and hence after refraction will pass through the focus. The ray which is passing through the optical center is going straight. It is undeviated. This is the focus, and the distance between the optical center and the focus is called focal length. As these rays are converging, this convex lens is called as converging lens. In this concave lens, these incident light rays are diverging after refraction. If you extend backward these diverging rays, you can see it meets at this point, and that is the focal point. The ray appears to diverge from this point, from the focal point. The distance between the focus and the optical center is called as focal length. As these rays are diverging, you call concave lens as diverging lens. We will learn about the image formation of spherical lenses in the next class. See you.